हरे कृष्ण टेक्स्ट 15 बियॉन्ड बर्थ एंड डेथ कुंती उवाच केचिद अहुर अजम जतम पुण्यश्लोकस्य कीर्तये यदो प्रियस्य अन्वये मलयस्य चंदनम सम से दैट द अनबॉर्न इज बॉर्न फॉर द ग्लोरिफिकेशन ऑफ पायस किंग्स एंड अदर्स से दैट ही इज बॉर्न टू प्लीज किंग यदु वन ऑफ योर डियरेस्ट डिवोटीज यू अपियर इन हिज फैमिली एज सैंडलवुड अपियर्स इन द मलया हिल्स केचिद अहुर अजम जतम पुण्यश्लोकस्य कीर्तये यादोः प्रियस्य अन्वये मलयस्य व चंदनम बिकॉज ऑफ श्रीमद भागवत 1.8.32 बिकॉज द लॉर्ड्स अपियरेंस इन दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड इज बिविल्डरिंग देर आर डिफरेंट ओपिनियंस अबाउट द बर्थ ऑफ द अनबॉर्न इन द भगवद्गीता द लॉर्ड सेज दैट ही टेक्स हिज बर्थ इन द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड ऑल्दो ही इज द लॉर्ड ऑफ ऑल क्रिएशंस एंड ही इज अनबॉर्न सो देर कैनॉट बी एनी डिनायल ऑफ द बर्थ ऑफ द अनबॉर्न बिकॉज ही हिमसेल्फ एस्टैब्लिशेज द ट्रूथ But still, there are different opinions as to why he takes his birth. That is also declared in the Bhagavad Gita. He appears by his own internal potency to re-establish the principles of religion and to protect the pious and annihilate the impious. That is the mission of the appearance of the unborn. Still, it is said that the Lord is there to glorify the pious King Yudhishthira. Lord Krishna certainly wanted to establish the kingdom of the Pandavas for the good of all in the world. When there is pious king ruling over the world, the people are happy. When the ruler is impious, the people are unhappy. In the age of Kali, in most cases, the rulers are impious and therefore the citizens are also continuously unhappy. But in the case of democracy, the impious citizens themselves elect their representatives to rule over them and therefore they cannot blame anyone for their unhappiness. Maharaj Nala was also celebrated as a great pious king but he had no connection with Lord Krishna. Therefore, Maharaj Yudhishthira is meant here to be glorified by Lord Krishna, who has also glorified King Yadu by taking birth in his family. He is known as Yadava, Yaduvira, Yadunandana, etc. Although the Lord is always independent of such obligations. He is just like the sandalwood that grows in the Malaya Hills. Trees can grow anywhere and everywhere. Yet, because the sandalwood trees grow mostly in the area of the Malaya Hills, the name sandalwood and the Malaya Hills are interrelated. Therefore, the conclusion is that the Lord is ever unborn like the sun and yet he appears as the sun rises in the eastern horizon. As the sun is never the sun of the eastern horizon, so the Lord is no one sun but is the father of everything that be. In the Bhagavad Gita 4.6, the Lord says, Ajo api shan avyatma bhutanam ishvaro api asan prakritim sva adhishthaya sambhavami atmamayaya. Although I am unborn and my transcendental body never deteriorates, and although I am the Lord of all sentient beings, I still appear in every millennium in my original transcendental form. Krishna is unborn and we are also unborn, but the difference is that unlike the Lord, we have been entangled in a material body. Therefore, we cannot keep our position as unborn but have to take birth and transmigrate from one body to another with no guarantee of what kind of body we shall receive next. Even in this life, we are obliged to accept one body after another. A child gives up his childhood body and accepts the body of a boy, and the boy gives up his boyhood body to accept a youthful body, which he then gives up for an old body. Therefore, it is natural to conclude that when one gives up one's old body, one will have to accept another body. Again, one will accept the body of a child. This is a natural cycle of this material world. It is similar to changes of season. After spring comes summer and after summer comes fall and then winter and then spring again. Similarly, after day comes night and after night comes day. Then just as these cyclic changes take place one after another, we change from one body to another and it is natural to conclude that after leaving the present body, we shall receive another body. Bhutva praliyate. This conclusion is very logical. It is supported by the Shastra, the Vedic literature, and it is also affirmed by the greatest authority, Krishna himself. Therefore, why should we not accept it? If one does not accept this, if one thinks that there is no life after that, one is foolish. There is life after that, and there is also the chance to free oneself from the cycle of repeated birth and death and attain a life of immortality. But because we have been accustomed to accepting one body after another since time immemorial, it is difficult for us to think of a life that is eternal. And the life of material existence is so troublesome that one may think that if there is an eternal life, that life must be troublesome also. For example, a diseased man who is taking a very bitter medicine and who is lying down in bed, eating there and passing stool and urine there, unable to move, may find his life so intolerable that he thinks, let me commit suicide. Similarly, materialistic life is so miserable that in desperation one sometimes takes to philosophy of voidism or impersonalism to try to negate his very existence and make everything zero. Actually, however, becoming zero is not possible nor is it necessary. We are in trouble in our material condition, but when we get out of our material condition, we can find real life, eternal life. बिकॉज वी आर पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ कृष्णा हु इज अज बियॉन्ड बर्थ एंड डेथ वी आर ऑल्सो अज हाउ कुड वी बी अदरवाइज इफ माई फादर इज हैप्पी एंड आई एम द सन ऑफ माई फादर देन वाई शुड आई बी अनहैप्पी आई कैन नेचुरली कंक्लूड दैट आई शैल एंजॉय माई फादर्स प्रॉपर्टी जस्ट एज माई फादर इज एंजॉइंग इट सिमिलरली गॉड कृष्णा इज ऑल पावरफुल ऑल ब्यूटिफुल ऑल नॉलेजेबल एंड कंप्लीट इन एवरीथिंग एंड ऑल्दो आई मे बी नॉट बी कंप्लीट आई एम पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ गॉड एंड देयरफॉर आई हैव ऑल द क्वालिटीज ऑफ गॉड टू बी अ पार्शियल एक्सटेंट God does not die. So I shall not die. That is my position. That is explained in Bhagavad Gita 2.20. Na jayate mriyate va kadachit. Described in the soul, Krishna says that the soul is never born. Na jayate. And if one is not born, how can he die? There is no question of that. Death. Mriyate va. Death is for one who has taken birth. And if one has no birth, he can also have no death. Unfortunately, however, we do not know this. We are conducting scientific research, but we do not know that every living entity is a spiritual soul with no birth and no death. That is our ignorance. The soul is eternal, everlasting and primeval. Nityah sasvato ayam puranu. The soul does not die with the annihilation of the body. Na hanyate hanyamane sharire. But although the soul does not die, he accepts another body and this is called bhava roga, the material disease. Since Krishna is the supreme living entity, nityo nityanam chetanas chetananam, we are exactly like Krishna. The difference being the Krishna is vibhu, unlimited, whereas we are anu, limited. Qualitatively, we are as good as Krishna. Therefore, whatever propensities Krishna has, we have also. For example, Krishna has the propensity to love someone of the opposite sex, and therefore we have the same propensity. The beginning of love is present in the eternal love between Radha and Krishna. We are also seeking eternal love, but because we are conditioned by the material laws, our love is interrupted. But if we can transcend this interruption, we can take part in loving affairs similar to those of Krishna and Radharani. Our aim should therefore be to go back home, back to Krishna, because since Krishna is eternal, we shall there receive an eternal body. Kunti says, Kechid Ahur Ajam, the supreme eternal, the supreme unborn, has now taken his birth. But although Krishna takes his birth is not like ours. That we should know. The Lord says in Bhagavad Gita 4.9, Janma karma cha me divyam evam yoviti tatvataha tyaktva deham punar janma naiti mameti so Arjuna. One who knows the transcendental nature of my appearance and activities does not upon leaving the body take his birth again in this material world but attains my eternal abode, O Arjuna. It is described in Srimad Bhagavatam that when Krishna first appeared, he did not take birth from the womb of Devaki. Rather, he first appeared in the majestic four-armed form of Vishnu and then he became a small child on Devaki's lap. Therefore, Krishna's birth is transcendental, whereas our birth takes place by force by the laws of nature. Krishna is not under the laws of nature. The laws of nature work under him. Madhyakshena prakritehe sruyate sa characharam. Prakriti, nature, works under the order of Krishna and we work under the order of nature. Krishna is the master of nature and we are servants of nature. Therefore, Kunti Devi says, Kechi the Huhu. Someone may say that the unborn has taken birth. It may appear that he has taken birth just like us, but in fact, he has not. Kunti Devi distinctly says, Kechi the Huhu. Some foolish persons may say that he has taken birth. Krishna himself also says in Bhagavad Gita 9.11, Avajananti mam mudha manushim tanu mashritam. Because I have appeared just like a human being, those who are rascals think that I am also just like an ordinary human. Param bhavam ajanantaha. They do not know the mystery behind God taking birth like a human being. Krishna is everywhere. The Lord is situated in everyone's heart. Ishvara sarvabhutanam hridadeshu arjuna tishtati. And since he is within us and is all powerful, why should it be difficult for him to appear before us? When the great devotee Dhruva Maharaj was engaged in meditation on the 400 form of Vishnu, all of a sudden his meditation broke and he immediately saw before him the same form upon which he had been meditating. Was it very difficult for Krishna to appear in this way? Of course not. Similarly, it was not difficult for him to appear before Devaki in the same four-handed form. Therefore, Krishna says, Janma karma che me divyam, one must understand my transcendental birth and activities. Kunti Devi has this understanding. She knows that although to some foolish fools, Krishna appears to take birth, in fact, he is unborn. But why should Krishna perform the pastime of taking birth? Kunti Devi replies, Punya shlokasya kirte, to glorify those who are very pious and very much advanced in spiritual understanding. Krishna comes as the son of Devaki to glorify his devotee Devaki. Krishna becomes the son of Yashoda to glorify Yashoda. Similarly, Krishna appears in the dynasty of Maharaj Yadu, his great devotee, just to glorify Maharaj Yadu. Thus, Krishna is still known as Yadava, the descendant of Maharaj Yadu. Krishna has no obligation to take his birth in a particular family or country, but he takes birth to glorify a certain person or a certain family because of their devotion. Therefore, his birth is called Divyam, transcendental. The Lord is not obliged to take birth, but we are obliged to do so. That is the distinction between our birth and the birth of Krishna. If by our karma or activities we are fit to take birth in a good family, in human society or demigod society, we shall do so. But if our activities are low like those of animals, we shall have to take birth in a family of animals. That is the force of karma. Karmana daivana trena jantor deho pattaye. Bhagavatam 3.31.1. We develop a certain type of body according to our karma. The human form of life is meant for understanding the Supreme, the Absolute Truth, Athato Brahma Jidnyasa. But if we do not endeavor for this, if we misuse this opportunity and simply remain like animals, we shall return to an animal form of life. Therefore, the Krishna Consciousness Movement is trying to save people from going down to an animal life. The appearance of Lord Krishna is compared to the growth of sandalwood trees in the Malaya Hills. Malaya Sheva Chandanam. There are two Malayas, the Malaya Hills and the part of the world now known as Malaysia. The Chandana trees or sandalwood tree can grow anywhere. There is no rule that it has to grow in Malaysia or the Malaya Hills. But because this sandalwood grows in large quantities in those parts of the world, it is known as Malaya Chandanam. In the western countries, there is scented water known as UD Kolon. It can be manufactured anywhere, but because it was originally manufactured in the city of Kolon, it is now known as UD Kolon. Similarly, sandalwood can grow anywhere, but because it was originally prominent in Malaysia and the Malaya Hills, it is known as Malaya Sandalwood. Kunti offered this prayer 5000 years ago, and this indicates that sandalwood was growing 5000 years ago in Malaysia. Malaysia is not a new name. It was known thousands and thousands of years ago to the followers of the Vedic culture. Nowadays, of course, Malaysia is growing rubber trees because there is a good demand for rubber. But formerly, Malaysia grew sandalwood on a large scale because there was a great demand for sandalwood, especially in India. Because India is a tropical country and sandalwood is very cooling, people in India use sandalwood pulp as a cosmetic. Even now, during the very warm days of the summer season, those who can afford to do so apply sandalwood pulp to their bodies and feel cool all day. In India, it was the system that after bathing and sanctifying the body by applying the marks of Tilaka, one should offer obeisances to the deity, take some Chandana Prasad from the room of deity and apply it as a cosmetic to the body. This was called Prasadhana. But it's said that in Kali Yuga, the present age, Snanam Eva Prasadhanam, Bhagavatam 12.2.5. If one even bathe nicely, that is Prasadhanam. In India, even the poorest man will take an early morning bath every day. But when I came to America, I saw that even taking one's daily bath may be a difficult thing and it is often not the practice. In India, we are accustomed to see people bathe thrice in a day. But in New York, I have seen that one may have to go to a friend's house to bathe because one may not have facilities to do so at home. These are symptoms of Kali Yuga. Snanam eva prasadhanam. In the Kali Yuga, it will be very difficult even to take a bath. Another symptom of Kali Yuga is Daksham Kutumba Bharanam, Bhagavatam 12.2.7. One will be famous for his pious activities simply if he can maintain his family. The word Daksham, meaning famous for pious activities, comes from Daksha, which means expert. In Kali Yuga, one will be considered expert if he can maintain a family consisting of himself, his wife and one or two children. In India, of course, the traditional family is the joint family consisting of a man and his wife, their parents and children, their in-laws and so on. But in Kali Yuga, it will be difficult to maintain a simple family of oneself, one's wife and few children. When I was living in New York, among the people coming to our classes was an old lady who had a grown son. I asked her, "Why does not your son get married?" She replied, "Yes, he can marry when he can maintain a family." I did not know that maintaining a family was such a difficult job here. But this is described in the Bhagavatam. If one can maintain a family, he will be considered a very glorious man. And if a girl has a husband, she will be considered very fortunate. It is not our business to criticize, but the symptoms of Kali Yuga are very severe and they will grow more severe. The duration of Kali Yuga is 4,32,000 years, and although 5,000 years of it have passed, already we find so many difficulties. And the more we grow into this Kali Yuga, the more the times it will be difficult. The best course, therefore, is to complete our Krishna consciousness and return home back to Godhead. That will save us. Otherwise, if we come back again for another life in Kali Yuga, we shall find difficult days ahead and we shall have to suffer more and more. And therefore, Kunti Devi reminds, Kechid ahur ajam jatam punya shlokasya kirtaye yadoho priyasya anvaye malayasya eva chandanam. Some say that the unborn is born for the glorification of pious kings, and others say that he is born to please King Yadu, one of your dearest devotees. You appear in his family as sandalwood appears in the Malaya Hills. Kechid ahur ajam jatam punya shlokasya kirtaye yadoho priyasya anvaye malayasya eva chandanam. हरे कृष्णा, विल कंटिन्यू फर्दर टुमारो।